Hello everyone, welcome to Dress My Craft YouTube channel. I am design team member Kanika Jain, and in this video I shall be talking about the alphabet capital letter die from Dress My Craft. But before moving forward, make sure you subscribe to our channel and turn on the bell notification so you're all updated. So let's get started. So that's how the capital alphabet die looks like. It is a set of 26 dies. The approximate size of these dies, the per die, is 28mm by 20mm. Now let me take out some of the dies and show you die cutting. So here I'm taking out H and I so that we can use the word hi. And here I'm using my Easy Cuts machine and I'm simply creating a sandwich, and I'll run it to and fro with the help of my Easy Cuts machine. And here you can see how quickly the die cutting has been done, and it was so simple. And with this you can customize your names and a lot more things. So here I'm using my ultimate die cleaning tool, and I have already uploaded a detailed video on that, so you can check that out as well. So let me show you some of the ways. So here I have created this banner, and I have used the banner punch. So if you have watched my last video, I have showed how to use the banner punch. And as well, you can use this banner onto your card and create this hanging. Doesn't this look beautiful? As well, you can use this as your cake topper. If you want to know more about this banner, do check out the last video. Here I am using a pre-cut note card and nicely creasing it down using the Teflon bone folder. And here you can see that, can you see the miss? So I have done die cutting and this is how it looks. So I have taken the dies and lined them up and simply did die cutting, and this is how it looks. So here you can use this in many different ways. So the first way is to use this directly. Second way is to use this as a stencil. So here you can see I have taken another white cardstock, kept it like this, and simply used my dye inks and used this as a stencil. So that's the second way. And the third way is how we are going to make it now. So first of all, I am simply adhering it like this. So here I am using my liquid adhesive. You can as well use your tacky tapes. So I'll place it down on the base note card like this. So first of all, you can leave it like this as it is and your card would look complete. But to take it another way, here I have the negatives which looks like this. I have stacked them up. So I have taken furthermore die cuts. Here you can see that it has got dimensions, so it looks like a chipboard. So I have stacked up 5M, 5i and 5s to both of them, and now I'm simply adhering them. So these will give the 3D look as they matches the base color of the card. So this will give a nice 3D look and this will pop out the card little bit. Just make sure you're aligning the letters properly, and now let's embellish the project. So for that, here I'm using the sequence family set from Dress My Craft. And as well, if you want to see a detailed video on this, you can check out the description box as I have already made a video. And now here I'm using a fine and sharp tip tweezers from Dress My Craft only, and I'm adhering it out. So if you want to know the uses of these tweezers, you can surely hop on to my previous videos. I have made a tutorial on this as well. And can you see how quickly our card is ready? Similarly, using the alphabet die, you can create names or words like hello or hi, or you can use them in your scrapbooks as well. Here you can see I have stacked this love, and now I'll show that how I'm stacking up the die cuts together. So here I have taken multiple die cuts and I am simply using my liquid adhesive and I'm stacking them up like this. So as per how thick you want, you can stack up your die cuts, and this will give a very nice 3D look. And then I'm going to embellish my fridge magnet, or you can say a frame, using this. I'll let them dry, and can you see how thick they have become? Now I'm adding the final layer. which is this one, and now I'll let this dry, making sure that I apply a good amount of pressure from the top. And can you see how beautiful this looks? So here I have my frame ready, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to layer these up here like this. Now I'm going to use a super strong liquid adhesive and I'm going to stick these over, and once I'm satisfied with the placement, I'll start adhering these out, and I'll be picking one by one. And here comes my fine and sharp tip tweezers handy, which helps me to hold these up and stick them up, and using the back side I can apply pressure so that the letters get stick very well to the base. And that's how you can embellish your frames as well. Or if you are into scrapbooking, you tend to write the names of your client or something like that, so for that as well you can use these alphabet dies. So I hope you enjoyed watching this video, and this one die set is one of the die sets which is very much versatile. So I hope you enjoyed watching this video. See you soon. Until next time, till then, happy crafting.